did your parents say?
I heard it in my spirit. I heard a beautiful sound, so I got very, very interested and promised myself that one day I'm going to make one. And it took about 20 years.
If you can, well, it is a short time to make the voice of angels.
Gerhard learned glass blowing in Germany. Later, he took his skills first to Paris, then to Massachusetts, where he began manufacturing complex scientific glassware. Making a glass harmonica remained a dream, until one day he realized he had the beginnings of an instrument right there in his shop.
He had a job for IBM, and the job was furnace tube. And I think I have one right here.
This is the tube you were making for IBM?
Yes, it was closed on both sides first, like this. Mm-hmm. And then one side had to be open. So what we did, we just cut it, and the piece that remained was, we cut it here, looked just like a glass harmonica cut.
This part piece would come off, this top
yes,
part?
Yes, and you throw it out usually.
And you realized at that point that you had seen the glass harmonica?
Yes, I thought, and it had a good sound when I touched it. It sounded beautiful already.
That first glass harmonica sold for $3,000, and slowly orders came in for more. So Gerhard started building them from scratch, still using the same high-quality glass of the IBM furnace tubes, but now shaping the cups to be more like Dr. Franklin's original design. This will become a pair of cups once it's sliced through the middle. Gerhard can't predict the exact pitch each cup will have, so he sounds each one to find what note is closest.
So that note is about 15 cents flat.
Fine-tuning is done by his assistant, Tim Nickerson, who grinds the front of the cup to raise its pitch. Tim's going to demonstrate how the cup makes its ethereal sound.
Now we're going to put this cup in this device, which actually uses an audio feedback loop to sustain the vibration of the cup. If you turn on the strobe light, you'll be able to see how much that wall is actually moving.
The strobe light appears to slow the vibration so we can see them.
That's amazing.
So is this circle of the top of the bowl getting bigger and smaller, or is
no, it's is just changing shape, like from a circle to an ellipse to an ellipse in an opposite direction?
Only a glass made of the purest quartz can withstand these vibrations. Here's a bowl made of ordinary glass. In the years after Franklin invented it, the glass harmonica became a big hit in Europe, where even Mozart wrote music for it.
But at a certain point, the instrument became unpopular. Do you know why?
Yes, I think there were several reasons. During a concert in a town of Germany, a child died during the concert, and the police found it in that particular town. They thought the instrument is the cause of the child's dying.
Why would they think that? Well, that's such an odd thing. I mean, if somebody died at a concert, you wouldn't blame the piano.
I know.
Nowadays. Or the saxophone. Why would they have blamed the glass harmonica?
Because there were rumors already known that it has supernatural powers, and when you play at midnight, the ghosts will come out. It's clearly stated in one of the books. Very thin, so it does not cut.
It's glass. It's like cellophane. Well, as you can imagine, I'm going to be playing this thing, but they won't let me play it until my hands are completely clean. So clean that they squeak. I don't know if I get a squeak yet. All the oil has to be off the fingers, otherwise you don't get a good sound. I think I hear it squeaking.
It's probably the only instrument in the world, in the history of musical instruments, where you pour water in it. Oh, excuse me.
Thomas Block has come from his native France, bringing his own special water to give me a demonstration of the instrument and my first lesson in playing it. The water comes from a particular cave in southern France and is rich in talc to improve the contact between Thomas's fingers and the glass.
Just on the top of a glass. The glass you want to play. This one.
I'm not getting a sound at all.
Where does it sound? It doesn't sound.
You hear something?
Thomas's special water doesn't seem to be working for me.
It comes.
That's pathetic.
He begins to cry. don't push.
This
don't
is
push
worse than when
strong.
I tried to learn the trumpet. What, don't push too hard?
No. You can play here also.
Then suddenly, with just the right pressure.
So now you can play with five fingers if you want.
A minute ago, I couldn't play at all.
Très bien, très bien.
Oh, merci.
Thomas Block is one of the world's leading glass harmonica players. Thanks to him and Gerhard Finkenbeiner, for a few moments we were listening again to the sound Ben Franklin himself had invented. For the record, nobody died, and we saw no ghosts.